Hello, how are you? Welcome to my channel. My name is Ruth and today I am bringing you the next in my series, the Love It, Pan It, Declutter It series, and today I am focusing on face powders. So with these videos, I do make sure that my base doesn't change for each product, so that the moisturizer I use, the foundation I use is the same when I try each of these powders, so that they're all on an even playing field, basically. Because if I was to be changing foundations or moisturizers or things like that, then it's not the same control, if that makes sense. I don't know if that's the right word to use, that people use when they're doing things like this. But yeah, you don't know if it's the base that has caused an issue or not. Does that make sense? I hope that makes sense. But yeah, so I used the same foundation. It was the Max Factor foundation I had in my project pan, and the same base products that I use every day, as in my serum, moisturizer, SPF, the same every day, so that each product is getting the same chance, basically the same fair go. Hope that makes sense. So I have at the moment in my collection 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 powders that I have tried out. Only 2 of them are actually pressed powders, the rest are all loose. And I would have said up to recently that I wasn't a huge fan of loose powders. I was more of a pressed powder kind of gal, because I had had, you know, the most hyped up and holy grail powder of them all. I had the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. I didn't like it. I used, I'd say, half it. I forced myself to use half of it, and I ended up giving it away to someone else. It just wasn't for me. And I took that to mean that I didn't like loose powders. Turns out that's not the case. You'll see as I go on here. But I have a couple of others in my collection that I haven't given a good go to yet. So I didn't want to include them in this because they've only come into my collection fairly recently. And I'm hoping down the line to do something like speed reviews, like kind of Jessica Brown and those do, where you pick maybe 5 products and just do a speed review on them. And I'd include them in something like that if people were interested. So yeah, I'm not going to include them today because I just don't feel it would be fair, because I haven't really given them a good go, if that makes sense. Anyway, cracking on. So the first one I'm going to start with is the e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder. This is what the packaging looked like. It's under 10 euros. You get 6.8 grams of product. e.l.f. is cruelty free. And it's a messy one, to be honest. I don't know if I'm even going to be able to. I can tilt it a little bit. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it though. When she focuses, she will. So it has a sifter top on it, so you can twist it closed. But unfortunately, I twisted it open. I'm going to close that now because we're getting very messy. I had twisted it open and forgot to twist it back and put it in my drawer and took it out. And now there's loads of product in the top. And for whatever reason, this one just does not go back down into the sifter. Joey, if you're trying to get it back down, it's like it's too thick to get back down through the holes of the sifter. But look, I get over it. And apart from that, it's quite solid. And maybe if I hadn't made that mistake, it would have been a good kind of packaging for a loose powder. But anyway, no scent to it. As I said, it's more or less translucent. Now it has kind of a tiny bit of a beige, a very light beige kind of tone to it. So it's not like a white, like a HD powder, that it does have a bare tint to it, but they consider it to be, they have called it light clear is the shade that they have described it as. I said the finish, it has a slight sheen glow to it. They claim it's a weightless feel, soft glow without shine. Smooths the looks of pores and fine lines. So the kind of brush then I would use, I meant to have these ready before, I'm not sure why would I use these kind of brushes typically for putting on powder. So not quite as big as like what I would use for a bronzer or that, but I typically will use this kind of brush, and then I will use that kind of brush for kind of under the eyes, a thinner, a smaller one again. So yeah, that kind of brush. And typically how I would use a powder is I'll put it in and then I will tap it on like a countertop or that to make sure the powder gets right down into the bristles, and then pop it on as I need it. Okay. So this particular one, I said it seemed okay, but I didn't love it first time out. It was kind of pretty undetectable. So what I mean by that was I didn't notice that I got, like, I would have an oily T-zone, not even oily as such, but a shiny T-zone. I think oily might be a bit of a stretch. And the rest of my skin then would be pretty normal. I wouldn't be too dry. But I didn't even notice that through the T-zone that it kind of took down the shine for me much. The particular day that I was specifically testing just this powder, I had said it was a hot day, completely gone, not a mattifying or long life product. So what I did with this then was I really focused in it for a good solid week just to try and really form my thoughts around it. I had used it prior to the testing and was just kind of okay about it, wasn't in raptures over it. So I retried it for a full week, actually ended up enjoying it. Perfect for meshing and blending other face powder products like blush, bronzer, etc. If using all matte products livens them up, don't need it, but nice to have it. So yeah, it's a finishing powder for me, not a setting powder, if that makes sense. So once I have all my bronzer, my blush, my highlighter, all that kind of stuff on, and other face powders, because I do need a different setting powder through here for it, and I'm not keen about it under my eyes. It is lovely to just really make sure that everything is blended together. So I put on the brush and just go really over everything lightly, and it just, there's no, you can't see a difference between your three products here, shall we say. It just meshes it all together nicely. So for me, and it does give a little bit of a glow to the skin as well, it doesn't deaden it, shall we say. For me, it's a nice product to have in my collection, but I don't need it. It's not something I would repurchase, but I will pan it. So it'll stay in my collection and I will pan it, but it's not necessarily something that I feel is needed. And like it says, it's a setting powder. I don't agree with that. I think it's more of a finishing powder, in my humble opinion. So that is the e.l.f. one. Next is one from Primark, and their makeup brand is PS, so Penny's in Ireland or Primark anywhere else. It's the Blurred Out Skin Conditioning Universal Blurring Powder. Superseed extracts, niacinamide, willow bark extract, refines skin's texture, brightens, boosts skin renewal. So it promises the world, moon and stars. I mean, it just is the second coming according to this. It's only €4. I didn't like this powder. Spoiler. The shade is universal. It's under €5. There's 7 grams of product, which I think is, just shows there's an excess of packaging here. But they're cruelty free and it has a little plastic sifter in it. I'm gonna take it off gently now because, and this isn't a sifter that you can twist on or off. This is just so potent, as in, I don't know if you can see even, but it just, no, I'm not going to be able to show really. It just wafts into the air and I feel like I'm inhaling it all the time. There's no scent to it. It's a very white kind of shade, like a kind of a HD powder would be. It's very matte. I again use a powder brush. So much powder kick up in the air as soon as you open it. My eyes felt so gritty, couldn't even put on eyeshadow. That's how bad it was. It was just, and I never felt like that eased up all day long. No, I just can't even lie. I'm like, do you know what it feels like? It feels like baking powder. Do you know the stuff that you'd use for bread or that? It kind of has that kind of feel to it. It's just the most bizarre thing. It's just not for me. Maybe somebody who has really oily skin might like it, but even then, it's just, I can actually feel it in the air and in my lungs. I said it's so heavy looking and matte, not for mature skin, in my opinion. So unfortunately, this is a declutter for me, but look, €4, I can't really complain about it. Yeah, it's the oddest, you can hear it, it's the oddest feel. I don't know who it would suit really. Maybe oily skinned people, I don't know, but I feel like even then it would be, see, my eyes now are weeping and all after it. But yeah, not for me. Not a product that worked for me. So that's a declutter, unfortunately. So we have a palette and a declutter so far. Next up is one that seems to be, well, I used it to, a kind of a one that divides people. They're the loved or hated. It's like Marmite. This is the Becca Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. Now, I won't say that I ever felt the hydro part of this very much. I know people love that part when they're disappointed when it goes out, but I never really noticed it. Now that does waft a little bit as well, but it just doesn't get in the lungs like the other one does. This has a little sifter in it, a little mesh kind of one, and I enjoy that. Again, some people don't seem to like it, but I do. I kind of turn it upside down and let it go into it, and then I can use my brush to just dip into it. I particularly use this on my under eyes. I love it on my under eyes and around here, through here. It just seems to really, it's the only powder I've ever used so far that I've experienced actual blurring of pores. I've never experienced that with a powder before, so maybe that's why I didn't think powders were for me either. It's translucent, under 30 euros, 10 grams in the full size, so good size. I actually bought a backup of the full size once I had got this, loved it, and then heard that Becca was going out of business. I said, right, let's buy a full size of this because I'm enjoying it that much and I've never experienced enjoying a powder that much before. I think it's worth getting a backup of. And in fairness, I have this since January and I've been using it consistently since then, and I still have plenty of product left, so this will probably do me a year. If Becca were staying in business, I would have probably picked up another small one of these kind of next at Christmas time when they come out in sets again. They're cruelty free, nice solid plastic with a mesh. The packaging I'm talking about there, sorry, the way I've written my notes. I like the mesh in it. I know a lot of people don't, but I quite liked it. No scent to it, and the colour, there's no real colour to it. It's not quite HD powder levels, and it's not a beigey colour either. It's kind of in between, and a satin finish. I said, I love how this makes my under eyes and pores look. First time I can honestly say they look better after powder. And to me, that's massive. Because, like I said, I'm 42. I have mature skin. I'm looking for products that are going to do me favors and not make me look worse. You know, that's the goal here. And I said, end of day, still looks great. This is a love it product. Absolutely, hand in heart, absolutely love it. So I'm glad I bought a backup of it. You know, there's sometimes, it's rare that I would buy a backup of a product because I have so much. I don't need to be buying backups. Excuse me, I'll take a sip. Yes, it is still roasting, for all of you wondering. Apparently the weatherman says, unseasonably warm. No shit, Sherlock. I know. I'm melting. Didn't need you to tell me that. What I need you to tell me is when it's going to cool down and I can enjoy autumn. Onwards. Next is the Catrice Glow Illusion Loose Powder in Translucent Radiance. They call it a fixing powder. So this is under 10 euros. There's 11 grams of product. Again, such small packaging for 11 grams. It just shows you it doesn't need to be a massive packaging. So this is a twist cap. I actually removed the sifter out of this because you could not for the life you get product out of it with the sifter that was on it. So I actually removed it altogether. Now it is a bit messy down the line. When I finish up a different powder, I think I'll move it into something else. It's no scent to it. The colour, it's a beigey kind of colour and it has a bit of a glowy finish. They claim it's an ultralight, light reflect pigment, smooth finish powder. And I say it's a very nice powder for all over the face, not glittery or too glowy. So any of these kind of powders, I worry sometimes that they're going to be a bit, you know, have particles of glitter or stuff like that. If this does, they're microfine and you can't detect them on the skin at all. Quite a lovely powder, I have to say. And like that, Catrice is cruelty free. They're affordable. You know, I can't really complain about it. I just thought this is a really lovely powder. And at the end of the day, I said it still looks lovely. So this has been a favorite for a while now in my collection. And Translucent Radiance, yeah, that's the shade. Yeah, really, really love this powder. So if you can get your hands on it and you like something that isn't completely mattifying, it does take down the shine a bit, you know what I mean? If you have a little bit of shine in the T-zone. And it does help with the longevity makeup, I feel, as well. But I just think overall it's a really lovely powder. It just, I think for more mature skins, it's a nice option. So that goes in the love it category. Next up is a Cover Effects powder. I only have a little teeny tiny one that I was gifted by a friend. This is the Cover Effects Perfect Setting Powder in Translucent Light. It's around 30 euros for 10 grams of product. This is obviously one that is a mini kind of sample pot. There's 1 gram in this. They're cruelty free. Big size has a sifter with a flip top lid, which I think looks really intriguing. I like the look of that. I think it looks well. And this little fella has the same. He's got a little flip top lid on him too. How cute. I usually don't get that kind of thing in a small product. You know, they usually try to, you know, just make it cheaper or whatever. Now, it is hard to get the product out. I won't lie, it is. But yeah, there's no scent to it. The colour is a kind of a light shade. It's not a white one as such, but it is quite light. I would say it has a normal finish. And what I mean by that is that it's not completely mattifying, yet it's not glowy either. It's just a basic powder. They claim airbrushed, finished, blur, smooth and perfect skin. I've literally said meh. If I could use the emoji, he'd be like, eh. Nothing special, but nothing bad. Doesn't really mattify, and I'm okay with that, because I don't like my skin to look completely matte and flat. It just doesn't suit me. But yeah, I can't say that this sample would entice me to buy a bigger size. So I think that says it all, really. Yeah, so this is going to go in the panette section of my collection. So I'll keep it. I'll use it up. It's only a small little one. I'll probably put it into a project pan fairly soon. Next up. Now, this is in different packaging because my friend Katie sent me a sample of this in a little little cute little tub. Because I'd always been curious about it. This is actually, I know it says Makeup Forever, but this is actually the Huda Beauty Easy Bake, Loose Bake, Baking and Setting Powder. I believe it's in Pound Cake. Correct me if I'm wrong, Katie. But God bless her. She sent it to me so that I could try it and see what I thought instead of having to buy a big size. But they've actually since spread out a little small one, which I think is a cute little thing. And I think my hesitancy with purchasing this one was the fact that everyone speaks so much about how scented it is. And I'm not keen on scents because my eyes are so sensitive. I try to not have too much else that can actually irritate them. Sorry, now, speaking of irritation, I'll give it a little dab. A lot of the leaves are falling at the moment, even though it's still warm, and I believe the mold from leaves can cause allergy flare-ups. I'm still taking my allergy medication, but they've definitely flared up today. So yeah, it's the big size, the full size is under 35 euros and there's 20 grams of product, which is a lot of product. Considering a lot of the other ones, they're like 10 grams for 30 euros and that. It's actually quite a good value for money when you think about it like that. She's cruelty free. Packaging, I obviously don't know because I haven't seen it, but it looks like it's a square plastic solid packaging with a sifter on it. So yes, there is a scent and I would describe it as being like sweet flowers. Like violets or daffodils or something like that. I don't hate it. God, this is such messy packaging for this, but I don't mind. Dab that off. The colour is kind of a pinky beige, I would say. It's kind of that particular one is kind of pinky beige. I found it to be matte but pretty at the same time, which I found quite odd. So kind of like that matte but not flat kind of powder. They claim it keeps makeup in place, blurs pores and fine lines and absorbs shine. Airbrush matte with a hint of sheen. And that's kind of accurate. Yeah, there is a hint, just a hint of a sheen. So it doesn't, while it mattifies what you need it to mattify, it doesn't leave the skin looking dead. Definite scent but not offensive. Dissipates pretty quickly. Mattifies without getting rid of glow. Now, I did say that at the end of the day, my skin felt a little bit itchy and I was concerned that it was due to the scent in it. But I actually consistently used this for a week after that because I wanted to see, was it that? Or was there something else? Was it just one of those days where your skin just feels a bit off or whatever? And I said I tried another few times and didn't notice further itching. So that was interesting. Look at the wasps. Lads. It's not fair. They should be gone by now. They should be long gone by now. And even though the weather is warm, I could be out there enjoying it without being plagued by stupid wasps. So I'm going to pan this, obviously, this little doodah. And after that, I'll make my decision as to whether I purchase it or not. I'm not sure that I love it just yet. But I don't hate it either. So I feel like if I was to use this little pot to completion, I'll have better kind of idea of how I feel about it. And like that, it's only a small pot. That'll probably still last me a year, not me. But yeah, so. Next up was a powder that I did originally like. This is the J.Cat Aquassurance Compact Foundation, it's called. And I have the shade Ivory. I'm going to have to be very careful here now because this actually cracked on me. Not in my handbag, not being thrown around the place. Literally in my drawer, this cracked. Whether I dropped it into the drawer or what, I honestly don't know, but I'm perplexed. So this has actually been repressed and it's cracked again. So yeah, I have the shade ACF 101 Ivory. This is under 15 euros here in Ireland. I got mine in, I think it was McSherry's pharmacy. You get 9 grams of products, they're cruelty free, and it's a good solid compact with a mirror, and it is. It's got a nice little mirror in it, and it has a kind of a section here where you can have a little powder puff thingy. And that's why I thought, yeah, this is going to be great for being in my handbag because I'll be able to touch up on the go. And it really does take down shine. So if you're getting a bit shiny during the day, especially in the summertime, it brings it down, giving you a bit of coverage at the same time. There was no scent to it. Now there is just pure alcohol. Because I don't know if I'm doing it wrong or if the ones that we have available to us over here are just very strong smelling. But I cannot. Anything I've repressed has been very strongly scented of alcohol afterwards, to the point where it's off-putting. And I worry because I put it on my face and I feel like I'm feeling a little tiny bit of burn from it. I could be just imagining that. I don't know. But I'm not loving it. And I've done all the things. I've left them open for days afterwards to let the scent. But it's just, I mean, I pressed this nearly 3 months ago now and I still can smell the alcohol so strongly off it. It's light beige, it's got a matte finish, and so what they said, because I want to read this because I think this is a bit, you're having a laugh, mate, kind of, what they claim. Some companies and their claims are just ridiculous. So listen to this. Cactus flower extract, an antioxidant property that helps maintain moisture of the skin. Chamomile, anti-inflammatory and calm the skin. Chlorelia, I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, improves production of the skin's collagen, which helps with skin's firmness and tone. Stop it now. Stop it. Don't be silly. That's, you know, no, I'm sorry, I don't, you know, no, just be a powder and be done with it. I don't believe that you can do any of those things. They might be in it, but I don't believe they can do what you claim they can do. Things like that annoy me. Maybe I'm completely wrong. Maybe it does, but I doubt it. Collagen in a powder. I'm skeptical. So what I do with this normally is I'd use my fluffy brush through the T-zone first and then just blend the edges. So I wouldn't dip back in. I just use what was ever left in my brush out to the edges because it is quite mattifying. Great for oily spots. Really takes it down. Would have thought a great touch-up powder, but broken my drawer, so too delicate for my handbag. Had to repress it. May have used too much alcohol as very strong smelling and seems to be irritating my skin. I don't think I'm going to keep this, guys. I think I'm going to have to declutter it because I'm just not happy with using it. And the fact that it's cracked again after repressing it is disappointing. So I think I'm going to have to let it go. I'm contemplating repurchasing it, but my problem with that was the whole point of having it is that it would be in my handbag as a touch-up powder. And if I can't do that, then what's the point in having it? Yeah, I don't know. I remember, I think it was Tati. Whatever you want to pronounce the name, that I first saw this on and she kind of convinced me to purchase it. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. And it's in my project 50 Shades of Purple because the teeniest, tiniest bit of purple on it. So I might need to bring something else in for that. See, it's falling out of the feckin' thing here. Yeah, I think this is going to go, guys. I think it's going to be a declutter. Anyway, next. This is another one from Primark. That they have done. It's only 250 lads for this one. PS, my perfect color, loose mineral powder, buildable coverage, matte finish, oil free, and I have it in Cool Sand 06, and you get 13 grams of product in here, lads, for 250. Ridiculous. They are, as I say, cruelty free. Packaging is messy. It's a flimsy plastic with a flimsy sifter, but you know, what are you gonna do for 250? I've actually put a little powder puff, a little thin one that I had, into it, if you can see it there, just to keep the powder in and not let it be going everywhere. And that's worked out fine. And I'm, you know, I'm okay with doing that. I've no problem with that. There's no scent to it. It's a beige kind of tone. So you, I don't know if you can kind of see there. It's quite a beige. It's not white in shade. I said it's matte again, but not flat. Buildable coverage, matte finish, oil-free are their claims. Application, light fluffy brush for light coverage, more dense, and tap into brush for more coverage. So you can use this, you see, as a mineral foundation as well. Kind of like the Bare Minerals. Jesus, it was gone there for a minute, lads. A similar kind of vibe to that. I said, my initial thoughts, so good for 250. Even though it's matte, it doesn't dull my glow. Looks better than some higher end powders. Wonderful. I mean, for 250 people. End of day, nice for summer. It can be used for minimum coverage or soaking up oil. So like if you had a day where you're just putting a tinted moisturiser or something on, you want a tiny bit more coverage in certain places, this is great for that. And overall, this is a lovely product. I mean, you just can't go wrong. Again, this is another one that down the line I'll possibly decant into a more luxe packaging so that it's easier to use. But other than that, I mean, I can't complain about the packaging for 250, guys. I just can't. Wonderful, wonderful powder. Love it. So that is that one. We've only two more to go, guys, and we're done. This is the Makeup Obsession Pure Bake Lace Baking Powder. And I think it was Jamie French I saw using this first, and she really loved it. And then I think it was Make Me Up Missa after that. Under 10 euros, you get 8 grams of product. They're cruelty-free. It's got a plastic twist top with a crap sifter. It's just rubbish. You can't even see the holes in it, it's that bad. But that's what the powder itself looks like. No scent to it, it's kind of a beige colour. And again, this is one of those ones that is mattifying but not completely matte. I said this wasn't matte looking but was mattifying, which is exactly what I want, as I've said numerous times. Didn't deaden the glow where I needed it. End of day, 'tis grand. And when an Irish person says something is grand, it's like, it's not brilliant, it's not awful, it's grand-like, it's fine, sure, what more do I want? So, this is a Panit powder. I should have said this at the start, I don't bake, I'm not a baker. I just don't think it suits my skin tone, or my skin type, the more matureness of my skin, and the nearly dryness. I don't feel I have dry skin because I hydrate a lot, so I thought I used to have dry skin, but I didn't. I had dehydrated skin, so I'd say I have normal combo skin. So if I had very oily skin, maybe I would bake, but I don't, so I don't bake. So yeah, this will, I'll pan it, it'll be fine. I'll keep it in my collection, there's no need to get rid of it, but it's not something I'll repurchase down the line. Last but not least is the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Airbrush Flawless Filter Skin Perfecting Micro Powder. Very shiny packaging. I have the shade 01 Fairy. You can see I have a nice bit of pan in it. It's in a project pan. This is just under 45 euros and you get 8 grams of product. Too rich for my blood, I'll be honest with you. They're cruelty-free. It has been confirmed now that Charlotte Tilbury has gone back into the cruelty-free sites, and that they're saying that she is cruelty-free again. Packaging, that's plastic, lads. That's not metal or tin or whatever you want to call it. That's plastic, which isn't good enough, in my opinion, when you're paying 45 euros. There's no scent to it. It's light beige kind of shade you can see there. And it has kind of, I would suggest, a satin finish to it. They claim smoothing effect finishing powder for flawless, perfect skin. Darlings, don't you know? Pore blurring, soft focus airbrush finish. I don't get it, lads. I know this is people's holy grail, but it's just, I don't get it. And I've literally written down, I don't get the hype. It's just fine. It doesn't emphasize dryness, but I don't find it good for under the eyes. And that's what I seem to see a lot of people who love this powder saying, is that they love it for their under eyes. I don't love it for my under eyes. I just don't. Doesn't keep shine at bay. Handy for touch-ups on the go. It goes in my handbag when I go places. Simple as that, because it's my only pressed powder. Dear God. Words, people. Words. Where do they go? I don't know. They just fly away. Yeah, I don't get the hype with this product. I just don't. It's in my project pan. I will use it to completion because it cost an arm and a leg. But it's not something I'll be... camera shut off, so I don't know exactly what I was saying at the time. I wish my camera gave me a warning when it does that, but it doesn't. Anyway, I was talking about Charlotte Tilbury. Don't like it, wouldn't repurchase it, will use it to completion. It goes in my handbag when I travel around with it. And that is it. That is all my powders. So yeah, what's your favourite powder? What is your go-to, never let you down, always there for your powder? What is the one that no matter what, you will always repurchase? And vice versa, what one do you detest? What one is majorly hyped in the community and you're like, but why? I don't understand. Because that's how I feel about the Charlotte Tilbury one. I'm just like, but why? But why? But, you know, different skin types means different things work for you, and that's just the way things go. But yeah, I'd love to know your opinions on powders. Do you like more mattifying? You know what I mean? Obviously, skin types play a big part into what your favourite is. Do you like pressed powders or do you like loose? What is your preference there? What do you think of the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder? Do you think that that's worth the hype, or do you think it's a completely overhyped product like I do? I was so disappointed because I was so excited when I bought it years ago. And I just thought, this is it, guys. I've met it. I have my Laura Mercier powder. I'm going to be the bomb. No, I wasn't the bomb at all. Very disappointed, little chicken ass. But yeah, that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it was in some part useful to you. But yeah, I'll chat to you in the next one. Take care, guys. Bye. Slán.